Meanwhile, one of the reasons that you are seeing price increases is not just the monetary phenomenon that has been created by the Federal Reserve over the course of the last 2 years and the Joe Biden plan to spend more money than God has ever seen, but also the problem with the ports, right? So we have these shipping bottlenecks. So let's talk a little bit about what exactly is happening with the shipping bottlenecks and why we have these shipping bottlenecks. So Dominic Pino, who writes for National Review, had a good piece in late September talking about this. He says, first, shipping is a global industry, but this crisis is largely an American problem. According to the 2020 World Bank HIS Market Container Port Performance Index, for example, not one U.S. port ranked in the top 50 global ports in terms of getting a ship in and out of port, according to Scott Linsicum, who writes for The Dispatch. The highest ranked U.S. port statistically was Philadelphia at 83, with Virginia close behind at 85, and New York, New Jersey at 89. Oakland ranks 332nd. L.A., Long Beach ranked a dismal 328 and 333, respectively. So why are our ports so far behind? Not because we don't spend on infrastructure, as the Biden administration would have you believe. The federal government could spend $250 billion on ports. It wouldn't change the contracts with longshoremen unions that prevent ports from operating 24-7, as they do in Asia, and send labor costs through the roof. According to Scott Linsicum, union dock workers on the West Coast are making an average dock workers, okay, of $171,000 a year, plus free healthcare. Pretty sweet gig. And when you sign crappy union contracts on behalf of the Port of Los Angeles, which is a government agency, when you do that sort of thing, what you end up doing is incentivizing less work. It turns out that rich union contracts, just like everywhere else in the American economy, tend to stagnate whoever the employer is and make it less effective. All the folks on the left who are big into unions, unions are the bulwark of the middle class. Well, it turns out the union contracts are very good for the people who are members of the union and have jobs. And for everyone else, there are serious externalities, and the ports are one of those casualties. The unions have been fighting automation at American ports for a long time because they're afraid that they're simply going to be replaced by machines. Also, according to this columnist for National Review, Dominic Pino, the pandemic is not the primary cause of the crisis. The pandemic merely immunized a crisis that was long brewing. Much of the current mess in the United States was decades in the making, reflecting systemic labor and trade policies that decreased the efficiency and flexibility U.S. ports and the economy reliant on them enjoy in the best of times and desperately need in the worst. The problems we are enduring now will not be solved by a pandemic emergency stopgap measure. They require real changes to the way the industry works that will be difficult to design and implement and will encounter heavy resistance from interest groups that benefit from the status quo. Okay, so we've got real systemic problems in the shipping industry that are brought about by really bad trade policy and really bad union policy. And all of this is not fixable by Joe Biden saying words. See, the way that shipping works, as Pino wrote back in June, is pretty complex. Right? He points out that the global shipping industry is still behind from the pandemic and likely will be for quite some time. That is because there have been canceled sailings, and ships only like to ship when they are, the owners of the ships only like to ship when the ship is completely full, because it takes like 3 weeks to send a ship from Asia to Los Angeles. It's not like a plane. If you have a cargo ship sitting in LA that's scheduled for Shanghai and the shipping line decides to cancel the sailing, that stinks for both the people trying to ship things out of LA and for people trying to receive things in Shanghai. But it also stinks for people trying to ship things out of Shanghai because the people running the Shanghai port were planning on using that same boat. They were planning on it being in Shanghai in 3 weeks. Now it won't be there. So you got 3 weeks worth of containers that pile up on the docks at Shanghai. So you might think they can wait for the next one, but every boat is scheduled to be full. So you end up with these giant backlogs. So all of this is a serious problem. We have a serious shortage of longshoremen in the United States. There aren't enough workers to unload them. And also, import volume from China via ocean shipping is up 54% year over year. Exports have only ticked up by 4.4%. So a lot of containers are leaving Asia, but not enough have actually been returning there. And you need those containers in order to ship things. So there are not enough ships. There are not enough containers to move more goods than ever before. Not enough workers to load and unload them. And that is going to drive up the prices. So Joe Biden's silly plan here is that he's going to order the ports to stay open for 24 hours. We'll get to why this is a silly plan in just 1 second. First, let us talk about a simple fact. That is that hackers, bad guys that are decent at crime, right? I mean, this is literally how they make their living. Well, if they can steal, you know, property from you, like physical property from you, how about all of those assets that are not material, right? They don't exist just in a safe at your house. Now, the Social Security Administration computer servers are 45 years old. Computer services at Health and Human Services are 50. Maybe that's how cyber criminals hacked U.S. Census Bureau's computers, where everything about you is stored. The threat of a cyber thief stealing your credit card, that's actually not your biggest risk on a personal level. The biggest risk is that somebody fakes ownership of your home. This is called home title theft. The FBI calls it one of the fastest growing crimes in America. Cyber criminals simply hack into vulnerable government, bank, or mortgage company servers where copies of your home title is stored. They forge your signature saying you sold your home to them and then borrow on your home and leave you in debt. You're not going to know until the collection notices show up. So go ahead and protect your most valuable asset today. Go to HomeTitleLock.com, register your address, see if you're already a victim, and use promo code radio for 30 free days of protection. Again, that is HomeTitleLock.com, promo code radio, HomeTitleLock.com. Okay, so the shipping shortages that are happening are not only Joe Biden's fault, but they are certainly partly Joe Biden's fault. Because as it turns out, when you drive prices up through inflation, and when you sign rich union contracts, and when you do all of these things, ignoring the realities on the ground, well, you end up with some bottlenecks. When you have labor shortages because people are staying home from work, when you tell people not to go back to work, when you tell people you'll pay them to stay home, and then you have labor shortages on one end, bottlenecks in the system tend to pile up. It's sort of like how traffic problems happen. If you ever think about a traffic problem, you think like, why are there traffic jams? Why don't all the cars keep moving? All it takes, studies have shown, is a couple of cars going on an on-ramp a little bit slower than the rest of traffic. And the downstream effects on a crowded freeway are pretty dramatic because people start slowing up behind and suddenly you have a bottleneck. So Joe Biden's plan is that he wants to keep the Los Angeles port open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. He pledged that this would relieve pressure on an overworked supply chain that has frustrated Americans and blossomed into a major economic shortcoming. There's only one problem with this plan. It is not going to do anything. Biden said that the announcement had the potential to be a game changer in unclogging the nation's supply lines. So here was Joe Biden trying to blame private companies for the shipping delays as opposed to, you know, the bad policy at the ports.
Today's announcement has the potential to be a game changer. I say potential because all of these goods won't move by themselves. For the positive impact to be felt all across the country and by all of you at home, we need major retailers who order the goods and the freight movers who take the goods from the ships to factories and to stores to step up as well.
So it's all about the private companies who aren't picking up their stuff. Okay, so here is the problem with what Joe Biden is saying, aside from the fact that the man is not with us. According to the Washington Post, no right-wing outlet, the extended hours the administration is touting represent something less than the full around-the-clock operations that are typical of the world's most advanced cargo-moving facilities. And this is what we've been saying. Our ports in the United States are operated idiotically. We don't have the automation. We don't have 24/7. We have longshoremen unions that are being paid an absolute fortune. The Port of Long Beach, which makes up one half of the nation's chief import gateway, began a pilot program late last month of late night and pre-dawn work. An administration official said Tuesday Long Beach had already gone to 24/7 and LA would be meeting that effort. But here's the thing, that's a lie. Only one of Long Beach Port's six container terminals works 24 hours a day, one out of six. It only does so Monday through Thursday. So it's not 24/7. Biden said the LA port would be open for 60 additional hours each week, but Philip Sandfield, port spokesman, said he couldn't say how many LA terminals will now be in operating around the clock. Gene Soroka, executive director of the LA port, said on Twitter, operational details are being discussed and worked out with supply chain stakeholders. Some industry executives described the administration's latest initiative, which the White House billed as nearly doubling the port's cargo handling hours, as incomplete. Matt Trapp, chief executive of the Harbor Trucking Association, whose members service the ports, said the measure will make a big difference only if terminals abandon requirements for truckers to return a specific type of empty shipping container before collecting a full one. Now, the problem with that, of course, is that if you don't actually have the empty shipping containers that are being returned to the port, then those ships can't leave, so they just stay there. And Craig Grosskart, senior vice president for Global Ocean at Seco Logistics, said, quote, "It will accomplish zero. It's just window dressing." Indeed. The administration said an additional 3,500 containers each week would move through the LA port during the new nighttime hours, thanks to promises from Walmart, FedEx, UPS, Target, Home Depot, and Samsung. The port expects to process almost 80,000 containers this week. So in other words, this is a minute upgrade from what was already being shipped in. The administration says giant companies will set an example that will spur others to follow, but longer working hours at the neighboring ports, which operated as a single complex under dual management, will only matter if trains, trucks, and warehouses all do the same. And truckers are reluctant to show up at the Long Beach port from 3 to 7 a.m. because they have nowhere to take containers at that hour. Nothing's open. Okay, so basically, Joe Biden is trying to slap a tiny, tiny Band-Aid on a giant problem that in the end is created by macroeconomic conditions that have been generated by the Federal Reserve and his work policies and bad union contracts and failure for years to upgrade the port contracts and how these things work. It turns out that bad policy has long, they have long tails, long downstream bad effects. Who's got two thumbs and wants you to like and subscribe?